Welcome to the program, sir.
Thank you for inviting me.
The UN Countering Terrorist Travel Program was launched in May this year. What are the first impressions and how efficient is the software so far?
Thank you for this question, because this is a flagship project for my office. And we got this technology from the Dutch government. And this technology is used in the European Union countries. Now 17 European Union countries have implemented this project, and it works. It works effectively. Secondly, the indication that this is a very effective technology is the fact that close to 75 countries across the whole globe asked us to start to implement this kind of arrangement. And this is a very important indicator, because if something is not workable, it's not efficient, there is no so many requests in this regard, in this case. So I think it's a very good product. There is a strong political will of a big number of member states. I think this is the number bigger than half of the countries, member states of the United Nations. And we have started the implementation of this project since May, as you rightly mentioned. And the first country in our list is Togo. Of course, this is the infrastructure which will be implemented out of scope of the European Union, because the European Union is doing this work by itself. But this program is designed globally, and I think it's the added value of this.
Obviously, the program requires a large database. Which countries contributed? How did the database formulate?
You mentioned the most sensitive issue in this case, but I think it's possible to agree with the countries to use the legislation of a number of countries which are in stage of implementation of this project. So the ground is prepared. It's necessary to find the right legal solutions for this issue. But the political will is in place. And if we manage to implement this project, of course, the security situation globally improved radically.
Are there countries which are not using the program? And if yes, why not?
You know, it's also an interesting question, because personal data is a product of the activities of the aviation companies. So it's aviation could exist only by sharing of this information. So I think no one country could be excluded from this technology, because this is absolutely global technology.
Do you think that terrorism can only be defeated by a universal approach, or should it be the responsibility of states to act against it?
Again, speaking about global and national in this regard, there is the necessary room for both factors, national and international. And I would like to congratulate the government of Hungary for organizing of this conference, because fighting terrorism, this is a national responsibility. And the international organizations like UN or European Union or others could create additional conditions for a more effective fight against terrorism. But the main responsibility rests on the member states. And this is the language of all Security Council resolutions, of all General Assembly resolutions, and global counterterrorism strategy. So I think any country should take care about the capacities on counterterrorism. And if it's not the case, country will be very fragile. And I am sure that terrorists could use this fragility to enter the country and to try to create chaos.
And what are the commitments that member states can do in order to defeat terrorism?
There are a lot of different kinds of activities, but again, prevention is the most important one. And I think this conference organized by the government of Hungary and by my office shows that the prevention should be a core issue of counterterrorism action. And I think that this is the main commitment, to understand the root causes and to try to address these root causes in an effective manner. So I think this conference will be very interesting discussion of different views with participation of civil society organizations. I think today's opening showed very strongly that countries should respect human rights obligations, should deal with counterterrorism in the framework of international law, and these are the main prerequisites to get rid from terrorism in a predictable future. This is a very difficult task, to defeat terrorism. A lot has been done, but more should be done in the next period of time, because this is the issue which could undermine the world order. This is a real security challenge.
Obviously, terrorism has become a major phenomenon in the past 20 years. Where is terrorism on the UN's agenda right now?
Very good question. Thank you for this question. We did analysis of the statements of the heads of governments and states during the last General Assembly meeting of the member states. So 116 member states emphasized that counterterrorism is among the main national priorities. So I think that this is the indicator that counterterrorism activities for the countries of the United Nations are really a very big challenge, and they should address this challenge. So I think it's very good indication, because if we would like to be successful, the international action, the common understanding what should be done in this regard is very important. Moreover, I could stress that this is the less politicized issue of the United Nations agenda, because no one country is immune. There is a common understanding that to defeat terrorism is possible only by common effort. And I think this is very promising, not only from the point of view of countering terrorism, but for creation of better understanding, for creation of trust and confidence among member states. And as for now, of course, we have a lack of this trust and confidence. And counterterrorism, effective counterterrorism, could help to restore this trust and confidence.
Mr. Vladimir Voronkov, it was a pleasure talking to you.
Thank you very much for this interview. And again, my congratulations to the government of Hungary for this very successful arrangement. Thank you.